In this example, we are going to construct a fluid around an object. We are going to create an emitter spline because we want the fluid to be directed by the spline that we have around the geometry. In the parameters of the spline emitter, we change the creation mode to edge mode. And finally, we drag the spline object inside the parameter spline object of the emitter. By connecting the spline inside the emitter, various fluid control points are generated within it, making it possible to change the behavior of the fluid as it is passing these areas. Once we have changed the parameters of the control point, which are adjustable depending on the type of simulation we wish to do, we press play to see what the simulation is like. As we can see, the fluid is quite fast, so we can add a drag daemon to control it. It's better not to change the speed of the emitter, rather how the fluid behaves, by varying its behavior. Now that we can see that the fluid is generating the desired effect, we can add noise to the particles to create a bit more chaos between them. Bear in mind that when we create a daemon and only one fluid's node exists in the scene, the daemon will be automatically connected to this fluid. If there is more than one fluid node, we must indicate which fluid inside the linked nodes. We are going to increase the speed of the emitter so that the fluid can follow the spline that we have assigned. We must generate as despline daemon and assign the spline the same way we did with the spline emitter. We can now see that the fluid is following the form of the spline. By default, the visualization of the particle speed in the viewport is set to a value between 0.05 and 5. We can change the value of this range to visualize the speed of the particles in the viewport in a different way. Once we simulate, we see that the particle's behavior is now how we expect. By default, the particles are going through the geometry since we have not set it to collide with it. So we add a RealFlow collider tag so that the fluid collides with the geometry. If the geometry has children, we can expand the collider tag to the children, pressing the right mouse button over it. Finally, we add a mesher to mesh the particles and see how it looks in the viewport.